Hello everyone, this is the peaceful revolutionary Sylvain Rochon speaking for another week. Vlog, sorry. I've been inspired these last few weeks about things that are not scientific, about things that are not technical. You could tell by some of the past vlogs. Today, I'd like to talk about slavery. It's something actually I've talked about on multiple videos to a certain extent, but not in with this angle. Essentially, we're all slaves. Well, most of us are. And I wanted, we've talked about this, but how do we actually unshackle ourselves? That's more the topic of this particular talk. Let's start off with why are we? Am I saying we're slaves? Well, it's pretty simple. The whole economical system, like the banking system, for example, has been set up and essentially is owned by a few individuals, a few families actually. It's a number of individuals on the planet. They own companies, they own the central banks in most of the countries of the world. And the central banks, technically and politically, and by contract, own most of the powerful, the most powerful nations, including the United States. Federal banks, for instance, and the U.S. is actually owned by people in England, for example, individuals, not the country itself, because they also own this federal bank, and the same people own the IMF and the World Bank and these things. So, and like you may have figured out, money rules the world, right? Money is power. A lot of people are trying to accrue some kind of the kind of money, and it's all about cash flow. Money is essentially a Ponzi scheme, in a really, really very, very real sense, in that it fructifies itself. Like that's why, you know, in banks you have interest earned on currency. It's supposed to be used as a trading medium, as a way to facilitate trade, but it's essentially something that grows on its own on the backs of people that generate the cash flow, and that's us. So we are part of the money-generating system to enrich certain individuals that own basically everything, including the countries, and are, you know, putting money in the pockets of some politicians and all that stuff to kind of keep quiet and keep things rolling, so that we can generate cash flow through taxes, getting money from working at jobs that keep the system up and running. So we are officially slaves of a whole system which has the sole purpose of generating new money and creating new money from our sweat and our efforts. That's a pretty pessimistic way to see the world, isn't it? Unfortunately, that's how the world is. Now, I've started this channel for multiple purposes, but the main purpose is revolution, a peaceful revolution. And that means change. Like we don't really like the idea of being slaves to a system that essentially educates us that the way we're doing things right now is the right way to go and the only way to go, where there's much better ways, much more logical ways to operate and run. Just looking at the basics, what do we need as humans? What do we actually need? You have the Maslow pyramid, which is fairly well known. At the base of it, we need some cover, like a, you know, some way to be secured from the environment. You know, like rain, snow. You know, to kind of be physically safe. We need that. We need food, sustenance, right? And that's another thing that we need to remain healthy for our body. That's very, very basic. So that's something that we need. And then at other levels, we need things like security. We need to feel secure. Otherwise, we're constantly afraid, and then we can't really reason or do anything productive in any way, shape, or form. So security is also, it's another layer, it's the second layer, but it's important. That's what we need. And some would argue, and I would certainly argue, that we also need to feel loved. Even to love, And that's a very general statement. It's just like for fulfillment of us being humans. Beyond that, everything else, I mean, there's other layers of the Maslow pyramids, but it's more social, let's just say. It's things that happen naturally that we're not really trapped into so much, and then we can provide for ourselves, and we can deprived of for a certain amount of times without a lot of ill effects, like the need for association, which is the higher levels of the Maslow pyramid. Now, if you look at really core things, we have food, lodging, like to be at secured from the elements, and also security, like feeling secure and love. These things are things we can provide for ourselves as individuals and as communities. Right? We can build our own houses and heating systems, fire, whatever it is. We can do that. We can farm, provide sustenance for ourselves. We don't really need a system to provide that for us. Everybody can agree on that? I mean, our ancestors did it for very successfully for a long, long time. And there's still countries in the world where there's no technology and really not a whole lot of system at all. I mean, they're able to live, even though they don't live very well, but we're able to do that. With technology and shared technologies, we can do it very, very, very well without an infrastructure to facilitate it. So without government and banks and all these systems that are in place. So ultimately, if you remove these systems, like we remove the even the educational system, although like that's not so bad, but you remove the banks, remove the governments, remove that. Keep the technologies, just remove the systems, right, that are kind of directing us in some ways. We can do rather well without those systems, with the internet and technologies and private companies. Private companies are not bad. They're trying to solve problems. I'm an entrepreneur, I understand that. We can do it everything ourselves. These systems that are what these individuals are owning, and they're owning us through it. We are feeding their system, a system that we no longer need, and we can live without. That's something that the people in that are ruling, essentially, not the politicians, of course, people one layer above or two layer above. That's what they're afraid of. They don't want us to notice and identify and to kind of figure out, it's like, wait, we don't need those systems. So they've put other systems in place to force us to use this. Like, did you notice that you can't really do anything without having a bank account? Like, for basically everything, you have to have a bank account. Why do I have to have a bank account? Like, really, it's, I mean, a bank account can be practical, I understand that. But why can't I keep money under the mattress, so to speak? Keep currency, keep gold in a safe. Why can't I just live on that? It's extremely difficult. You can do it, but it's extremely difficult. We have to have a bank account for a lot of stuff, like having employment. Like, try having any kind of employment without a bank account requirement. It's very difficult. There are some out, like being paid under the table, so to speak, like in cash. Yeah, it's being paid cash, no problem. You can keep it in your safe, golf bag, whatever. But it's very difficult. It's very difficult even nowadays to do a lot of things without a credit card or at least a debit card, which requires a bank account. And so we're slaves to the banking system, even if you're unemployed. In many ways, like the government is going to require you to have a bank, and they're sending checks over to you to. Even if you're on welfare, well, what are you going to do with a check if you don't have a bank account? You can't feed yourself with a check. You need to turn it over to the bank, use banking services, pay interest, and pay fees to cash in your check. We are imprisoned in this system, right? And we're paying into it. And we work. When we get educated, we are educated to get into the job market. To get a good job, be a nice Canadian, American, European, Chinese, whatever. right? Get a good job, pay your taxes, so you feed into the government system, right? You use the banking system because you gotta kind of have to. And then at the end of your working life, retire from money you put in from your hard work, and hopefully die soon thereafter because you're a burden to society. Like, I'm talking from the perspectives of those people that are in power. I mean, they don't want to pay out as much as possible. They want to keep things. So it's like, once you're retired, hopefully, you'll perish as soon as possible. Pretty terrible. Now, what is the solution? This is just the state of things. Like, what do we do to get ourselves out of this, to be a peaceful revolutionary? Because again, it's like there's no sense in being violent about it. And I've mentioned it before several times. What do we need as a diff like since we're kind of caught into it? A lot of people, they don't know what to do, so they stay in the system because it works for them. Like they live and they eat, and, they get things done. According to the Maslow pyramid, they get all these the elements covered. So what we need to do is we need to create a new way of doing things that is not dependent on these systems that are designed to enrich a select few individuals on the planet. So we essentially need to collaborate and work together. We need to create a new way of doing things. So, one way of doing it is by not being an employee. That helps. Because that's part of the system. I'm pretty much integrated part of the system. I'm a consultant. I'm an entrepreneur. That's one step removed from the whole system. Even though I have to use the banks and I have to do things, but because otherwise I can't really work very efficiently. But there are ways to get out of that as well if you're courageous. If we stop, if or we find ways to avoid using the systems, using the banks, bypassing government, because we don't need the government. It's another control system. Religion is a control system. Some of the countries are owned by some religions, financially and officially. We'll check it out. So if we try to rule ourselves through the internet as individuals, we can, like I mentioned before, like the system called Paradism, where we can just manage ourselves. And it's actually started a little bit like in the city of Mexico. I mentioned that they're creating a new constitution for Mexico City as a district, but they're crowdsourcing the ideas for the constitution. So that's a start of bypassing the government in some way. And doing a people doing things for themselves instead of using a system in place that is essentially financed and funded as a means of illusion to give us a sense of control that we are having actually or actually have choices in how we're directed and how we generate laws. We can do that ourselves as individuals, not as companies and governments that are owned and owned and owned by others, ultimately by the same individuals. So we need to do that with money and currency as well. We need to use our own way of doing things, like Bitcoin as an example of a currency that can be used for trade that is not part of the banking system. Okay? So we need to keep doing efforts at doing that. We need to look at every possible way to avoid using the systems. And the system, if a sufficient number of people do that, the systems will shrivel and die. Because ultimately, like really, we have always had the power. We have the power of getting everything done. We are the energy behind those systems that drive it and provide its sustenance. If we refuse to use the system as much as possible or reduce its usage to the minimum we can, and there's enough of people that do that, the system can't sustain itself. And it dies, and it is replaced by whatever we choose. We have already chose, essentially, to use to replace it. So find like peaceful revolutionaries out there. Find alternate ways to manage money. Now, use insurance companies, which are private firms that are owned by other individuals, maybe not the same ones, as a banking system. There are books out there that illustrates how to do that. You can use that as a banking system of some sort for savings and for retirement, and to actually use like an actual bank account. You can do that. Don't vote. Don't encourage the system of government. Do express your ideas through social media, as vlogs. Spread the word that way to other people, so that everybody is aware of what should be done. It's and filter it to the top, so that more and more individuals, like the higher powered individual, actually can make things happen, and group people together can make some that happens. Some groups are out there. For example, I've always been amazed by the Zeitgeist movement. I put down the links below for a lot of this stuff. They have lots of chapters all around the world, and they're trying to find alternate ways that are around those systems of control. And if enough, like I said, if enough people use the alternates, the primary systems that makes us slaves will necessarily die. Now, there's a danger to that, because pretty much every powerful individual that has tried to directly confront those systems, bad stuff has happened to them, like JFK, Lincoln, others. I doubt they'd go after me for my little vlog. But of course, they don't want the system to shrivel, because they're losing all their power. But we are the power. We're the ones that are feeding it. If you don't want this something to survive, don't feed it, right? Do something else. Use another system. Build another. Don't use another system, but build. Do get what you need from other ways, like get your food from, partner farmers or gardens from the store, like directly. Don't, but use it. Use you get it. You through. Geez, I can't talk today. Get it without using money, if you can, which is collaborative sustainability communities, for example, are where there's no money. Everybody is kind of shares ways to grow food, and then the food is shared. That's one thing. Trade your skills to receive to get money into your household, for example. That's another way. Why not? But there's a lot of different ways we can attempt to do this. For housing, same thing. There's like the Earthship group in Arizona, for example. Started in Arizona. They build each other houses using a simple architectural design that are very sustainable, very earth friendly, and then they live there. They still have to pay tax for the land and stuff, because they're still living in the U.S., but they're not using banks for mortgages, to mortgage their homes. They build them themselves, so they have that covered. They have their house. They have food covered, and a lot of it is growing in their houses. Actually, that's part of the design of sustainability. And they live in a place that is, fairly secure, being the States, and it's not super super dangerous. The more we push toward in that direction, even though it's not perfect, the less we feed the system. So that's all we need to do. If everybody pitches in and does something, it makes a difference. So I encourage every one of you to check out the Zeitgeist movement. Check out paradism.org. I have the links in the discussion down. I also posted in the discussion a link that kind of summarizes how the system works and how it feeds and how we're slaves. In a very, I mean, the website is kind of crappy itself, but I thought it was kind of summarized a lot of the connections to that fairly well, and it has external links to all to everywhere where you need to research this and beyond. So it's a good read. I mean, that's why, I mean, the site's just full of ads. That's why I'd say it's crappy. I just don't like all the ads in there, but it's actually a good article for reading, with lots of links. So read up on that, and instead of tomorrow or Monday, because it's Saturday for me here, just going to work and do the same thing every day like you've always done as a good little Canadian, American, European. Try to think about, well, what can I do? How can I do? What can I do in my life that removes myself one more way out of some of the systems? Like the educational system is an issue, but the institution itself is not a problem to me. It's just we're provided education that is based on politics of government, and that's where we get railroaded. So we just need to change the curriculum, I guess, not the actual educational system, although it does need reform, but that's a different topic. So I hope you all can understand, actually, at the very least, how much power you have. Here's an analogy, just to illustrate a bit further. Everybody knows that, like, to go to a soccer game, or some people call it football in Europe. If you want to go to a soccer game, like the World Cup, it's going to cost a lot of money for a seat, right? Why does it cost so much? Well, it's because there's a lot of people that want to have those seats. It's an offer and demand principle. It's business. A lot of people want to sit in those seats. People are willing to pay hundreds of dollars for some of those seats, especially like in the World Cup and stuff like that. So they increase the price because they know they can fill all these seats at that kind of particular price. There's a lot of demand for those seats, right? People want those seats. What if publicly soccer becomes less interesting or undesirable because we discover there's a problem with soccer, for example, whatever. Okay, there is no problem with soccer and football. Don't worry, but I'm using it as an example. But if there was some kind of scandal around soccer, the price of the ticket prices for the seats would be lower. Why? Because there's less demand. People don't want to do it anymore. You don't want to contribute to that economy, that microeconomy, which is soccer, football, and stadiums and these kind of things. And if at some point there's just like sufficient disinterest, well, they have to close the stadiums, and people can still play soccer, but it just won't be any attendance. Or they're going to have to sell the seats for $5, and even then, maybe if it's so undesirable, they need to kind of shut everything down. It's the same thing with the economical system. If we keep dealing with it and using money and being employees and doing what they say and using the bank systems like they want, and more as much as possible, as many products of the bank as possible. If we do that, well, we need we're showing that we need it, and we're using it, we're financing it, and they increase the prices. It's the same as the football field. If there's enough demand, they increase services, prices, they increase everything because there's a demand for it, and the people at the top, the individuals that are making the real money and the real control, they keep their control, they keep making money. If enough people just say, well, this is corrupted, don't want to be a slave anymore, I don't want to do this, do that, I don't want to have a bank account if I can help it, kind of removing all these credit cards, all these mortgages, live in a sustainable house, and it's just I'm not voting anymore, like all this stuff. If you can do that, then the system starts to die. The ticket prices for the seats go down. Now the banks start to ask us, okay, like, come here. We're going to give you stuff now because they want to keep us. And then we still say, no. You are a bad system. You're a parasite to humanity. And the individuals of humanity are not there to enrich a select few. We're there to take care of everybody else as equals, make sure everybody has what they need. And then it keeps going down, down, down. Less people use it. They become more and more desperate because they want to fill seats. They lower the prices, and we still refuse. And eventually, it has to go away because it's just not sustainable. It is a business to them. If it's not sustainable, they'll try to find other ways, but they'll just shut it down. if enough people don't go to the football game. Okay? So that's what we need to do. So I'm hoping you're all gonna jump in with me. Small pieces at a time, or big pieces if you want to make great moves. Check out the information on Zeitgeist. Check out the information on what's really going on. And start planning now for your own personal revolution. Getting away from the banking system, getting away from all the governments and all this, and work more and more with individuals, with groups that want to share, collaborate, trade, so that you can get everything that you need, but not through the systems in place that want to just use you and use all of us. And we'll all be happier for that. So I hope you're with me. Are you with me? I hope so. Anyway, so that's going to be it for today. I sure hope the revolution is coming, like the real wave is coming, and we can shut these things down and work without money. And we don't need to work anymore. We have the technology to do that. We can keep everything, all the advanced technology that we have, using technology without the systems, without money, without the economy, and have a beautiful life without any war, without any more famine anywhere. And just beautiful collaboration. It's all possible if each individual that has supreme power over all this stuff decides not to provide their power, to give away their power to the systems. Have a good week.